dangerous pathogens could be headed to Earth. But don't freak out yet.
We're not taking any chances.
To prevent a Martian plague, NASA is building a first-of-its-kind biocontainment lab to study samples from Mars.
The question is, once they come into the atmosphere, where do you bring them in order to ensure that not only those samples are safe, but also the population is safe?
It's going to require this really fascinating lab. It's basically going to be the world's most paradoxical HVAC system.
To get it right, NASA is visiting labs that contain some of the most dangerous pathogens, and we got to go to one.
I'm sorry you did not get to see Ebola or smallpox.
I was going
to
be very careful.
Do you actually think that you're going to have time to build the lab, get it all ready for those samples to come back?
We are on a pretty tight schedule. It's just a matter of properly prioritizing.
Time is getting tight. So the question is, will we be ready for whatever is discovered on Mars? This is Just Might Work, a show about surprising solutions to our biggest problems. NASA is facing a monumental task, again. The mission to bring Mars samples to Earth is another extremely complicated one.
Touchdown confirmed. Perseverance safely on the surface of Mars.
Here's what needs to happen. The Perseverance rover collects samples from the surface and atmosphere on Mars, drops them on the surface, which is picked up and launched into orbit, then shot into space and captured by another vehicle, which will ultimately drop them onto Earth. And the last step relies on Dr. Andrea Harrington. She's responsible for designing and building the biocontainment lab that will allow researchers to safely study the Mars samples collected. Because when they finally make it back to Earth, they could pose a threat to humanity.
The risk is really low. That being said, we're not taking any chances, and we're taking a very conservative and safety-first approach.
This mission that's decades in the making is all to answer two questions. Did life ever exist on Mars, and could we live there?
So it is possible, and it seems like this is the case based on geological evidence, that Mars was actually quite similar to Earth. We're going to Jezero Crater, which is thought to have been a former lake bed. So there could be some sort of fossils or some evidence of past life within the samples.
Every time we bring back samples from another world, either the asteroids, the moon, we find something new. And there's larger discoveries about how the solar system formed and how planets formed.
And that's what's at stake. What we bring back from space could have pathogens that threaten our civilization. To mitigate that risk, NASA is learning from its past.
This is the home of the largest collection of lunar samples, and on that corner over there is actually the largest display of lunar samples in the world.
So why is it important for you to be in a lab like this as you prepare for Mars samples to return to Earth?
All of the equipment that you see in here will inspire or be used to help design the equipment for the Mars samples. So you see this positive pressure glove boxes behind us, they are filled with a very specialized inert nitrogen environment. That's an inert environment to make sure the samples stay pristine and don't degrade over time. That's why we can have so much great science 5 decades later.
The facility NASA is engineering is unlike any lab that exists on Earth. So Freethink writer B. David helped put it all into context.
Biocontainment labs come in multiple levels, 1 through 4, and 4 is the most secure. When you picture a biocontainment lab in your head, you're probably thinking of a BSL-4 lab. There's only a handful of these around the world. This is where you can study the most dangerous agents. These are lethal agents, they're often exotic, they often have no vaccines or therapies. When you're coming in and out of these facilities, it's a whole process. You have to change your clothes, put on these like suits. Everyone signs in and out. When you leave, you have to take a decontamination shower. It's a whole to-do. You're sort of entering a whole new world.
We actually got to see this up close in Boston at the National Emerging Infectious Diseases Laboratories. We'll just call it Needle. It's one of the containment labs that Andrea and her team visited.
This is the training facility. The requirements for working inside a level 4 laboratory are so different than in a level 3 and a level 2 lab that we have a specialized space to allow us to train people.
So there's nothing dangerous in here?
This is not a lab that is certified to allow you to bring any living thing into it except the pathogens that we all have walked in here with ourselves.
Sure. Yeah.
Members of NASA and the Jet Propulsion Laboratory came and visited, and they were interested in how current biosafety level 4 labs are built, but also whether or not those could be modified at all for the purposes of bringing samples back from Mars. So these are suits that are built in a way that they will keep air.
Because the air is getting pushed into the suit, it has positive pressure, sort of the opposite of the lab. So if there was a tear in my suit, the air is going to come rushing out of the suit and keeping things in the lab away from me.
Kind of like the suit, NASA needs to create a lab with a negative pressure paradigm to keep anything from escaping, while also creating a positive pressure environment so they don't contaminate the samples.
So this was designed to house the most pristine of the pristine contamination knowledge samples for Mars sample return. So the items that are gonna be stored in here are already also gonna be in a vacuum bakeout case, but it's a fail safe because this will be, it's gonna be a box within a box, which is a typical thing that we're doing for Mars to make sure the samples are as safe from us as possible.
Building all of this is just part of a step in the process of preparing for the Mars sample returns, but it's being used potentially for other samples that are coming back within the next 10 years.
Yeah.
Very cool.
I think it's incredibly fascinating what science is capable of doing. I think people maybe underestimate our abilities in this regard. And I consider something like a biosafety level 4 laboratory where we can really safely look at some of these really dangerous biological agents and viruses to be an important achievement for science.
The Mars samples are expected to land on Earth in 2033. It seems like a long time, but a lab so specialized is going to take nearly a decade to design and build.
While the chances of a Martian plague happening are probably really slim, I do think it's important that they take it seriously, because if it were to happen, it's gonna be really bad. We saw how bad it can get with something that already lives on Earth. I wouldn't wanna know what happens otherwise. I think it's worth the investment, just in case.
Over the past number of years, I think that there is a resurgence or a growing need for high containment facilities. We're doing something that's never been done before, and that's exciting.
I mean, I grew up in the space age, and this is something I would have never envisioned from years ago. I think that NASA certainly has the scientific minds to be able to make this work.